Morning, YouTube. Today we're here on the side of the freeway. It's on the opposite side of the, actually by the riverbed. We got this call from Kruger Tow. They always give us a lot of calls when they need the big rigs. Had to come in through that little small area over there. You could see all the transients, all the trash they accumulate and store here from stolen stuff that they take all the time. But anyways, we have this dump truck that I guess they stole and put over here, and then it burned. Who knows what happened, but it's burnt. Missing wheels, missing all kinds of stuff. Well, I gotta get a frame hooks. So my plan of attack is simple. Lift it and put it on my three axle flatbed, industrial bed, which Shredder's bringing. Big Joe. So I'm most likely gonna use my frame hooks. Come over the top and the front, some axles, yeah, maybe from the axles, some chains, should be easy. Just gonna park my truck on the side of it, avoid all these rocks. Some of these rocks are jagged, they'll puncture my tires. Tires are expensive, so it's not a puncture them. This area is pretty dry, so not a very huge risk of sinking. Even though that big flipper is very, very heavy. Drone, so you can see an aerial view. As you can see right there. That's a dump truck. We even have a little tire shop in the back. We have the gentleman from Kruger, the driver, cutting off that excess hood. Make my job a little easier, which is nice. just to show you where the mess that we have here. See all that stuff that's just thrown around, trash. So the entrance is actually over on that street, which is Imperial. Let's take a flight over there. Which is right there, actually. They come on that little street and back up all the way down here, down there, and there it goes. Come all the way down here and us again. Have grab hooks.
Who was flying the drone?
I was.
Oh,
yeah. So I have my frame grab hooks that grab around the end of the frame and all the way up. Normally I use a spreader bar for a type of for these type of jobs, just so I don't crush anything, but this is gone, so I'm not even gonna worry about that. This is beyond salvageable and repairable. That engine stuff is gone, so this is not a big deal. Obviously you guys know that I'm a huge advocate for stuff like this, but for this, really not a big deal. For this, I'm just gonna go and grab around somewhere in this vicinity. Over around here and just go up. I'm gonna grab this from the frame here. I don't know how much to that. Yeah, staying busy?
Got a little bit slower, but
uh-huh.
Still there.
I think it's slow everywhere, man.
Everywhere, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, it's been slow everywhere, man. Everywhere, but I've been asking around, everybody's been pretty slow.
I mean, we're still running calls, but our yard's starting to look empty.
Yeah, you could tell, right? Yeah. More releases than there is impounds. Those ports are slow, man. Can you pass me those blue ones, please? Thank you, sir. Phone, like always. Hello. Yeah, where are you at? Thank you. 5,000? Yeah, see how it looks clear?
Oh, yeah.
All right. It should send up to 5K on that sensor. Yeah, it's pretty simple. So this one, say forward, back, obviously side. This on this joystick is up, down. The side, it spins to the opposite counterclockwise.
It comes with everything, the cameras and everything?
Yeah, it comes with everything, the camera. The only thing that you have to buy extra is the batteries, the filters that go in front of the camera. If it's too sunny, it looks overexposed, it looks white. So you have to put like a little filter in the front to block the sunlight so you could see the image quality. All right, we shoot in log, which is like the image looks almost like desaturated where it doesn't have any color. And then on the editing software, you add the color to it. Yeah, it captures more of the detail. If it's too dark, it looks grainy. It looks kind of like you see like spots and you see like little grain there. If it's overexposed, it looks too white. So you kind of have to get it pretty much in the ballpark, and then the rest is in editing. And this is what we used to put in our YouTube.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've seen the videos.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, thanks, man. So now I'm going to go ahead and lift off little by little. It's on rocks, so I don't expect to come up super, super smooth, but we will try. See? There it is. See? That's exactly why. These transients have it on wood planks, so. Again, move some of the rocks out of the way.
We're gonna back up right here.
Yeah, I'm just gonna get rid of this first, and then I'll swing it this way, and we get that so that we're not under the load. These transients make jacks out of everything, huh? Crazy. I'm gonna swing it this way now. Yeah, he's backing up already. Joe up here. Hey, you want to go at an angle or go through here? Straight?
I like that over there better.
Let me swing it.
Yeah, I couldn't see that. Thank you.
Good job, Joe. Bad mofo. Round the money. Round the money. One shot.
No PTO needed.
No PTO.
Bad mofo.
I gonna wanna put rubber pads under here? I have some.
Yeah, or wood.
Yeah?
We got wood.
Yeah, I know, like this.
Or runway thing.
However.
There you go, sir.
Going down big. You got around the money.
You have to pull my up out of nothing now.
Let me put the front first. Should we put it on the axle? What do you think? Nah, it's fine right there, right? Right here?
Yeah.
All right. It's gonna roll. Should we chain it down?
Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly what
I'm
gonna tell you.
Okay,
let me do that down.
I'll hold it down. What happened? Yeah. You got the floods on? Oh, you hit our lawn, huh?
No.
Yeah?
I specialize in it. Yeah, it was moving, bro.
Right now,
Look, I'm good right there.
Good?
Good here.
Okay.
And then I'm going to need a bunch of motorcycle stuff in there.
We're going to offload over there, no? We're going to offload a Kruger? Yes, sir.
Look at the flood.
So I could see.
There's no people. You'll see the chains up there, no?
I know.
So we're going to need a bunch of swag or a bunch of
I got straps. I got straps. Since we're gonna offload at Kruger tow, I'm just gonna leave my chains here. A sense of de-rigging. Okay, pass me one of those straps, man. Please. And a ratchet. Thank you, man. That is funny, look at. I dropped it and look how it landed. Funny. guys, it's pretty much strapped down with the help of the driver from the cooler. There are little straps right so the doors don't open. Big flipper there, so we're just gonna take it back to their yard, offload, and call it a day. Set to go. All right. Peace out, guys.